Don't you wish you could execute force follow shots like the pros, using maximum topspin and fast speed to force the cue ball forward for shape on the next ball? If so, you're in the right place.
Look at this for a shot. Look at this. Look at this for a shot. How do you like them, Albin Ocean?
This video offers technique advice that can help you be much more effective with shots like this. A good way to develop and improve your follow shot technique is to practice drills like the follow drill in the first Billiard University or BU playing ability exam. The goal is to pocket the object ball and have the cue ball follow forward to the rectangular target. Gradually increase the distance from the target pocket until you can master the shot from up table. Try to make as many shots as possible from the largest distance to develop and improve your accuracy and consistency. If your tip is not high enough, the shot is very difficult. It will require fast speed, and you still might not follow forward enough. Faster object ball speed also makes it more likely to rattle out of the pocket if your aim is not accurate. If you instead use a much higher tip position, you can use much less speed, giving better accuracy and control with the least effort. Here it is from the side, showing how high the tip can be. With slower object ball speed, the pocket plays bigger if the aim is off a little. A standard striped ball can be used to help visualize the miscue limit. If the tip contact point is below the edge of the stripe, the shot should be safe. The chalk mark on the ball clearly shows that I was safely within the miscue limit. Again, don't be afraid to aim high on the cue ball. Also make sure the cue is as level as possible. If the back of the cue is elevated, the cue ball will hop into the object ball. If the cue ball hits the object ball while airborne, the object ball will be overcut with what appears to be an accurate aim. For more information, see the link in the video description. With a follow shot like this, it helps to use the end rail to control your speed. You don't want to risk coming up short of your target like this. Planning to hit the foot cushion instead gives you a much larger margin for error with speed. The speed on this shot would send the cue ball well past the target if the rail were not there, but the killing action of the cushion holds the cue ball in the target area. Even with a much slower speed, the cue ball still finds the target. Just like with a lag shot, this is the ideal speed to strive for where you reach the cushion. That way, if you use a little less or a little more speed, you still end up in your target area. If you have cue ball in hand, as with this drill, it is bad strategy to try to have the cue ball head straight to the target like this. If your aim is off a little, you can scratch. It is better to angle the shot slightly to have the cue ball come off the side rail to avoid the possible scratch. But you don't want the cue ball too far from the side rail, where the angle into the cushion could send the cue ball into the side pocket point. Again, it is best to position the cue ball closer to the side rail so the cue ball will come off the cushion above the side pocket, where you are safe from the side pocket point and a possible scratch in the corner. To perform follow shots well, it helps to have good technique. It is best to have a slow backswing, a non-rushed transition, and a full, relaxed, and smooth acceleration into the cue ball, resulting in a complete follow-through. You don't want to rush and jerk the stroke with tension like this. If you're the kind of person who doesn't like drills and doesn't think this sort of shot is useful, here's a simple and common game situation where it is important to be able to execute shots like this with accuracy and consistency. I need to pocket the last stripe and follow forward for shape on the 8. These skills can win you games. Here's an example power force follow shot from the 3rd BU playing ability exam dealing with advanced shots. The goal is to pocket the 1 and get shape on the 2 with force follow off the foot cushion. With any power shots, it helps to use a longer bridge length so you have more room to generate cue speed smoothly. And remember, go back slow, don't rush the transition to the forward stroke, stay relaxed, smoothly accelerate over the entire bridge length, and keep your head and body as still as possible. This sort of shot would be much easier on a table with bouncy cushions like a diamond. The cushions on my Olhausen are not very bouncy, so more follow speed is required. Here's another game situation where you might think force follow is a good play. I need to pocket the 3 and get the cue ball up table to pocket the 8 in the side from above. But when the cue ball angle into the cushion is shallow like this, force follow can result in a scratch. I can't draw straight back here because the 10 and 11 are in the way. Following forward at medium fast speed, the cue ball bounces off the cushion, but the cue ball doesn't have enough speed to go up table. But using more speed to send the cue ball farther up table causes the cue ball to bend back toward the rail after rebound. The best way to guarantee a shot at the 8 here is to go rail first with draw. It is fairly easy to aim since the 3 is close to the cushion. The follow straightening effect can cause trouble even for the pros at times. Here, it happened to Shane Van Boning twice in 3 shots. The scratch on the last shot cost him the game. For more information, see the link in the video description. I hope the advice and techniques in this video help you be more effective with force follow shots. Good luck with your game from Dr. Dave. Thank you.